Hi guys, a very good morning to all of you. I hope you all are doing good and preparing well for the upcoming examination as well as celebrating the New Year vibe around us. I am Gulapsa, your mentor for Finance Current Affairs, and I welcome you once again to another session of RBI 247. And in today's session, we are going to talk about three very important finance-related current affairs. The first one talks about the regulatory framework that IFSCA, the Global Financial Regulator, has issued for distribution of capital market products and services. Secondly, we'll talk about how and why SEBI has extended the suspension of derivatives trading in commodities product. And third, why SEBI has approved the phasing out of shares through the stock exchange process. So, in teen news ko samjhenge, starting with the very first news, that is the regulatory framework for distribution of capital market products and services. Ab dekho, any regulator, let's say RBI or SEBI, ya fir IFSCA ko utha lo, what is their objective? Their motive or objective is to develop the market or to develop the area they are regulating. So it is to develop and regulate the process, how the entire system is functioning. Similarly, with the case of the Global Financial Regulator, IFSCA, in order to regulate and develop the IFSC centers, the International Financial Services Center, they have come up with the regulatory framework for the distribution of capital market products and services. Abhi capital market products and services kya kya hote hain? So this capital market products and services constitute of, if we talk about the products, they will be the same as mentioned under the Securities Contract Regulation Act of 1956. So, SEBI ke andar jo bhi capital market products hai, wahi same products aap IFSC mein bhi dekh sakte ho. Now, IFSC mein kya honge ye capital market products? So, it will consist of shares, stocks, debts, debentures, आपके डेरिवेटिव्स भी आ जाएंगे. तो जितने भी कैपिटल मार्केट प्रोडक्ट्स हैं वो सारे कॉन्स्टिट्यूट करेंगे प्रोडक्ट्स अंडर दिस फ्रेमवर्क, और उसकी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के बारे में ये रेगुलेटरी फ्रेमवर्क लाया गया है. नाउ व्हाट विल कॉन्स्टिट्यूट द कैपिटल मार्केट सर्विसेज? सो दिस सर्विसेज विल इंक्लूड टू टाइप्स ऑफ सर्विसेज. फर्स्ट इज द पोर्टफोलियो मैनेजमेंट सर्विसेज, पीएमएस के बारे में हमने डिस्कस भी किया था इन वन ऑफ आर प्रीवियस वीडियोस. एंड सेकेंडली इन्वेस्टमेंट एडवाइजरी सर्विसेज, द सर्विसेज वेयर बाय दे प्रोवाइड एडवाइजेस ऑन द इन्वेस्टमेंट मेड बाय सोफिस्टिकेटेड इन्वेस्टर्स और अदर इन्वेस्टर्स. तो इनकी डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन के बारे में ये फ्रेमवर्क लाया गया है. नाउ दिस फ्रेमवर्क हैज बीन इशूड अंडर IFSCA Capital Market Intermediaries Regulation 2021. अब आपको पता है that in the domestic market some of the services are not allowed, and for that matter the IFSCA center was brought into picture by the government so that they can compete with the international level. तो इनका जो भी करने का तरीका है, the entire working process and functioning is aligned to that of an international stock exchange. इसलिए we have this IFSCA, the International Financial Services Center Authority, as the financial market or the global financial market regulator for India. ठीक है? और इसके अंदर जो हमारे पास International Financial Services Center है, that is in operation is none other than the GIFT City. And therefore it becomes important for us to have it broad understanding of IFSCA and the regulation that they are coming up with. So I hope ye aapko clear ho gaya hoga. Now let's move forward and talk about other things. Now apart from this distribution of the products and services which we have talked about recently, it also states that this distributors can cater or provide services not only to the sophisticated investors in the IFSCA, as apart from that they can also provide such services to other investors. So jo koi bhi investor hai who wants to invest in IFSC can do so, but for that the distributor will have to have higher level of diligence, and also they should provide only restricted set of products and services to such investors. Aisa kyun? Why is this distinction here? अगर आप सोफिस्टिकेटेड इन्वेस्टर्स की बात करो, दे हैव दैट फाइनेंशियल एक्यूमेन एंड दे अंडरस्टैंड इन व्हाट they are investing. However, for other investors, for the normal people, they do not have such financial knowledge, and for that only restricted products and services should be provided so that they are not exploited, first and foremost. And secondly, it is easier for the distributors, for the one who is providing the services, to manage them well. So this is the rationale behind why restricted set of products and services will be made available to investors. Ab iske andar kya aa jayega? For example, there are structured financial products, SFP bhi hote hain, jo humne recently bhi discuss kiya tha. So such structured financial products will not be made available to this other investors. However, they will be made available to the sophisticated investors. Moving forward, काफी normal है, generic है, but we just need to go through it. The next is about distribution or collaboration with other distributors. So the regulation or the framework says that the distributors in IFSC can also collaborate with other distributors, and such a collaboration with other distributors will be known as associated distribution. और जो दूसरा पार्टी होगा जिसके साथ IFSC के डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स कोलैबोरेट कर रहे होंगे, दैट विल कॉन्स्टिट्यूट और दैट विल बी नोन एज एसोसिएटेड डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स. ठीक है, एंड सच कोलैबोरेशन कैन बी डन बिटवीन डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स फ्रॉम इंडिया, फ्रॉम IFSC और फ्रॉम एनी अदर फॉरेन ज्यूरिसडिक्शन. तो इंडिया का कोई भी इन्वेस्टमेंट सर्विस प्रोवाइडर है या let's say portfolio management service provider hai with them or other distributors in IFSC or any other globally bhi aap collaboration kar sakte ho in order to provide the products and the services to the investors. Now the question arises, what is the rationale behind that? Very simple, it will widen the scope of operations for these distributors as well as it will provide them a larger pool of investor base, because if collaboration happens, both of them will bring their investor base and there will be a larger pool of issuers and service providers as well. Now moving forward to the next point, which says that these IFSCA registered or licensed entities, agar there are certain entities in the IFSC center, such as let's say the finance companies, the banking units, or the brokers, the dealers, the investment providers, the portfolio management service providers, all of them will be considered as a distributor under this framework, provided they apply for a simplified registration process as given under the framework by IFSCA. So jitne bhi financial services providers hain, वो सारे भी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटर्स की तरह काम कर सकते हैं एंड दे कैन डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कैपिटल मार्केट प्रोडक्ट्स एज वेल एज कैपिटल मार्केट सर्विसेज. सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट टॉक्स अबाउट नेटवर्थ रिक्वायरमेंट. अब बहुत सारे बैंकिंग यूनिट्स होंगे, SBI का जो फॉरन ब्रांच होगा या जो ब्रांच होगा IFSCA में वो भी होंगे, या फिर छोटे बैंक के ब्रांचेस होंगे वो भी होंगे, राइट? But we cannot take all of them as distributors. Therefore, there is a criteria known as the net worth requirement criteria. And according to that, all those distributors or all those eligible distributors should have a minimum net worth of $50,000 at all times. So, unko itna net worth hona chahiye, and then only they will be considered as a distributor under this framework. Moving forward, also apart from all these technical legal details, there is also a comprehensive code of conduct that needs to be followed and compiled by all the registered distributors, the associated distribution in case if there is a collaboration, and other distributors that are empaneled by IFSC and who are distributing this capital market products and services. तो पूरा एक कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट है एंड दैट हैज बीन लेड डाउन बाय IFSC, उनको इसको फॉलो करना है. नाउ व्हाट आर द कोड ऑफ कंडक्ट, दिस आर नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट फॉर यू फॉर द एग्जाम, बस आपको इतना ध्यान रखना है, राइट? मूविंग फॉरवर्ड टू द नेक्स्ट न्यूज टॉक्स अबाउट द एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द सस्पेंशन ऑफ डेरिवेटिव ट्रेडिंग in agricultural commodities. So the story of this dates back to last year, wherein in 2021 SEBI banned or imposed a ban on डेरिवेटिव्स ट्रेडिंग ऑफ एग्रीकल्चरल कमोडिटीज. तो 7 एग्रीकल्चरल कमोडिटीज पे सेबी ने बैन इम्पोज किया था. दीज कमोडिटीज वेर पैडी, नॉन बासमती राइस, देन वी हैड व्हीट, चना, मस्टर्ड सीड्स, सोयाबीन, क्रूड पाम ऑयल एंड मूंगा. तो इनपे सेबी ने बैन लगाया था दैट यू कैन नॉट ट्रेड दिस कमोडिटीज ऑन द डेरिवेटिव ट्रेडिंग ओवर द एक्सचेंजेस. ऐसा क्यों किया सेबी ने? फॉर द सिंपल रीजन दैट सेबी फाउंड दैट दीज कमोडिटीज वेर क्रिएटिंग वोलेटाइलिटी इन द प्राइसेज ऑफ गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज, इन द प्राइसेज ऑफ दीज कमोडिटीज. तो इनकी इन कमोडिटीज की प्राइसेस में बहुत ज्यादा वोलेटाइलिटी देखने को मिल रही थी एंड दिस वोलेटाइलिटी वॉज लीडिंग टू फूड इन्फ्लेशन. तो बहुत ज्यादा फूड इन्फ्लेशन भी हो रहा था अल्टीमेटली विच लेड टू इन्फ्लेशन इन दी कंट्री. तो इसको कंट्रोल करने के लिए सेबी ने ये बैन लगाया था एंड रिसेंटली दिस बैन वॉज फॉर जस्ट फॉर 1 year टिल 20th December 2022. बट सेबी हैज अगेन एक्सटेंडेड दिस बाय अनदर ईयर टिल 20th December 2023. तो नेक्स्ट ईयर तक ये बैन को इम्पोज किया गया है बिकॉज सेबी वॉन्ट्स टू फर्दर एनालाइज एंड एग्जामिन वेदर such ban will reduce the volatility caused in the prices of these commodities. So this was the news, but let us talk about the consequences. Kya is ek saal mein whether the volatility that was seen in the prices of these commodities has actually gone up or down? So according to several agri or agricultural commodity bodies, they found that the ban that was imposed by SEBI has done more harm to them than the good that was expected, because by using the derivatives market for the commodity price, for the commodities, these agricultural commodity bodies found it very useful because it helped them to hedge their price risk. Apart from that, they were also able to get price signals which helped them in better pricing and in having better informed decision on the commodity prices. So ye sari cheeze thi, and despite the ban, as we have talked about, it did not result in taming the volatility, because throughout the 2022 we have seen that food inflation has been increasing. It is only in the recent month, that is in November and in December, that food inflation has actually been eased down. So yahi cheez hai, this is the impact. And the agri commodity market, the bodies has also said that these well functioning futures market, so derivatives mein wo kis market ka use kar rahe the, the futures market has actually helped the producers, the processors, the importers as well as the exporters of these agricultural products to get reliable price signals, and uske according wo apne commodities ko price kar pa rahe the and could have taken better informed decision. बट बिकॉज ऑफ द बैन ये सारी चीज़ें रुकी हुई हैं. बट द पॉइंट फ्रॉम सेबीज पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज नो डाउट डेरिवेटिव्स प्रोवाइड्स विद द फैसिलिटी ऑफ हेजिंग प्राइस रिस्क एज वेल एज इट प्रोवाइड्स सिग्नल्स फॉर द प्राइसेस. बट वी शुड नॉट फॉरगेट दैट अलॉन्ग विद दीज बेनिफिट्स डेरिवेटिव्स आर ऑल्सो एक्सप्लॉयटेड बाई द स्पेक्यूलेटर्स. सो दीज स्पेक्यूलेटर्स कैन एक्चुअली ब्रिंग डाउन द प्राइसेस टू वेरी लो और कुड टेक दैट प्राइसेस टू वेरी हाई इफ प्रोवाइडेड इफ दे हैव डीप पॉकेट्स. तो वो अपने इफ दे हैव वेरी डीप पॉकेट्स दे कैन एक्चुअली डिसाइड वट विल बी द प्राइसेस of the commodities. इसलिए speculation को ध्यान में रखते हुए SEBI has extended and SEBI wants to actually examine and come up with something more reliable so that the our agricultural derivative market is more competitive globally and it can be used as a reliable instrument for price discovery as well as for risk hedging without the danger that such commodity market will be exploited by the speculators. So isko curtail karne ke liye, isko kam karne ke liye the extension has been done by SEBI. So I hope aapko ye bhi samajh aa gaya hoga. You just need to understand the pros and the cons of having this suspension on commodities trading by SEBI. Moving forward to the third news. Now this third news we have talked about in very brief when the proposal was introduced to SEBI. In continuation to that news only, the news is that SEBI has finally approved phasing out of shares buyback through stock exchanges. So you all must know और आपको पता होगा कि शेयर बायबैक क्या होता है. व्हाट इज शेयर बायबैक? शेयर बायबैक ऑल्सो नोन एज शेयर रीपर्चेज. सो वेन एवर अ लिस्टेड कंपनी वॉन्ट्स टू बाय बैक इट्स शेयर्स फ्रॉम द मार्केट, ओपन मार्केट से अपने शेयर्स को वापस खरीदती है, दैट इज नोन एज बाय बैक ऑफ शेयर्स. एंड सच बाय बैक ऑफ शेयर्स कैन बी डन ओनली बाय अ लिस्टेड कंपनी जिसने एक्चुअली शेयर्स को मार्केट में इंट्रोड्यूस किया था. राइट नाउ व्हाट इज द लिमिट टू विच share buyback can happen for any company? So the maximum limit for which a buyback can happen is 25%. So 25% or less is the limit for buyback of shares or any other securities by the company. Now this 25% is of the summation of the paid up equity capital of the company, jitni bhi paid up equity capital hai, plus their reserves. So iska 25% aap बायबैक कर सकते हो एज अ कंपनी. नाउ व्हाट विल बी द इम्प्लीकेशन ऑफ बायबैक? सो व्हेनेवर द कंपनी रीपर्चेजेस इट्स ओन शेयर, द नंबर ऑफ आउटस्टैंडिंग शेयर्स विल गो डाउन, राइट? एंड देयरफॉर द ईपीएस विल बी बेटर. सो इट मीन्स दैट देयर विल बी अ बेटर इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ द शेयर्स ऑफ द कंपनी और द वर्थ ऑफ द कंपनी. अब आपको सबको पता है ईपीएस क्या होता है. ईपीएस स्टैंड्स फॉर अर्निंग पर शेयर. पर शेयर आपकी कितनी अर्निंग है. सो आउट ऑफ द टोटल प्रॉफिट यू फर्स्ट प्रोवाइड फॉर द इंटरेस्ट दैट यू हैव टेकन ऑन द डिबेंचर्स और द लोन्स दैट यू हैव टेकन. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट यू ऑल्सो डिडक्ट एनी काइंड ऑफ डिविडेंड दैट इज टू बी पेड टू द प्रेफरेंस शेयर होल्डर्स. जो भी प्रॉफिट बचती है दैट विल गो टू द इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स. सो द प्रॉफिट अवेलेबल टू द इक्विटी शेयर होल्डर्स डिवाइडेड बाई द नंबर ऑफ आउटस्टैंडिंग शेयर्स constitute the earning per share of a company. तो अगर हमारा number of outstanding shares कम हो जाएगी, that means the profit or the earning per share of the company will increase. Therefore, every shareholder who remains in the company will have better earnings per the number of shares that they have held with the company. And therefore, there will be a better evaluation of the company. So this is share buyback. I hope aapko samajh aa gaya hoga. One more thing, share buyback ko hum share repurchase bhi bolte hain. Now this share buyback can be done in two methods. So every company has been given two methods currently to buy back their shares. The first method is known as the tender offer. And the second is known as the open market offer. Open market offer ko hum stock exchange method bhi bolte hain. Exchange method ya exchange offer method. So first and foremost is the tender offer. Tender offer kya hota hai? Here the buyback of shares happens on a proportionate basis. Proportionate basis ka kya matlab hua? So suppose let's say there are 100 shareholders aur sabne kuch shares अपने पास रखे होंगे. लेट्स से दिस पर्सन हैज 10 शेयर्स, दिस पर्सन हैज 20, दिस हैज जस्ट 5, दिस हैज 25, लेट्स से दिस हैज 75. लेट्स से तो सबके पास सबने कंपनीज की शेयर रखी हुई है. इन सबको ऑफर दिया जाएगा कंपनी के द्वारा थ्रू एन ऑफर दैट द कंपनी इंटेंड्स टू बाय बैक इट्स शेयर्स. एंड बेस्ड ऑन द प्रोपोर्शन लेट्स से 100 शेयर्स आर टू बी बाय बैक. अब ये 100 शेयर बस एक बंदे से नहीं लिया जाएगा. लेट्स से देयर इज अ पर्सन who has 125 shares with it. So, बस एक बंदे से आप share buyback नहीं करोगे, on a proportionate basis, सबसे share buyback किया जाएगा. And therefore, this tender offer provides the opportunity that every shareholder is being asked in at times of share buyback by the company. Also, in case of share buyback usually happen at a higher price. तो जो भी मार्केट प्राइस होगी किसी शेयर की उससे हायर प्राइस पे ही कंपनीज बायबैक करती है अपने शेयर को, राइट? सो अंडर द टेंडर ऑफर द मेन बेनिफिट इज दैट एवरी शेयर होल्डर इज गिवन द अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड द बायबैक हैपेंस ऑन अ प्रोपोर्शनेट बेसिस. द प्राइस इज हायर देन द मार्केट प्राइस ऑफ द शेयर. ऑल्सो द प्राइस इज फिक्स. लेट्स से इफ द मार्केट प्राइस ऑफ वन शेयर इन द मार्केट इज 100 and the buyback price is 125, then 125 will be the price for every shareholder. However, in the case of open market offer or the stock exchange offer, the buyback happens through a book building process. Ab IPO mein aapne book building process ke bare mein suna hoga, whereby bidding happens and based on the bidding, share prices are determined. Similarly, in case of open market or the stock exchanges offer, first and foremost, bidding of the prices will happen, and based on the bidding, the buyback of the shares will be done by the company. Or in other cases, this stock exchange method or the open market offer are also done on an odd lot holders basis. Odd lot ka kya matlab hota hai? Let's say all the persons who are having less than 50 shares, in sare shareholders se aap buyback kar lete ho, so that these small shareholders do not, because wo na hi aapke voting mein itna zyada role play karte hain, na hi decision mein play karte hain, therefore they want to eliminate all the smaller shareholders, and therefore this odd lot holders or odd lot method is also applied to the open market offer. So I hope aapko method samajh mein aa gaye honge. The detail has been provided in the PPT. Open market kya hota hai ye aapko bataya gaya hai. Also, in case of open market offer, the promoter or the person in control of a company is not allowed to participate in the exchange route or the exchange offer, and it happens on the stock exchanges, and therefore it is also known as the exchange method. And buyback is done only through order matching mechanism. So jaise humne last mein example liya tha, that's if suppose a company wants to buy back 100 shares and there are like 10 people, and let's say someone had 20, someone had 125, someone had 75. Agar is 125 ka match kar jata hai with the bidding price, in that case only this person gets the opportunity to sell back the share to the company, aur baki jo chote shareholders hote hain wo reh jate hain, and in many times they are unaware as to when the buyback of the company is done. Isliye the rule or the approval that SEBI has given is that it will phase out the share buyback method of buyback of securities or shares by the company. So ye jo method hai buyback through the open market or the exchange route will be phased out by SEBI in a gradual manner, and that will be starting I think from 2025. So this is the news. Ab aage badhte hain, tender offer kya hota hai, I have talked about it, aur yahan pe acche se diya hua hai, you can go through it, whereby it says that a letter of offer will be provided to every shareholder and buyback will be done on a proportionate basis, and the price at which the buyback will happen is fixed in case of tender offer. However, in market offer wahan pe book building process use hoti thi, and it is usually higher. And also there is a provision for the small shareholders in case of tender offer, whereby 15% of the buyback size, agar 100 shares buyback hone hain, uska 15%, that is 15 shares will be reserved for the small shareholders, ki wahi buyback ya fir वापस बेच सकते हैं कंपनी को, एंड ऑल द शेयरहोल्डर्स ऑन द रिकॉर्ड डेट आर एलिजिबल टू पार्टिसिपेट इन द प्रोसेस ऑफ बायबैक अंडर द टेंडर ऑफर. जबकि ये केस नहीं है हमारे स्टॉक एक्सचेंज मेथड में, जहां पर ऑर्डर मैचिंग की जाती है, और उसके जिसके साथ ऑर्डर मैच हो गई उससे ही कंपनी बायबैक करती है अपने शेयर्स को. सो आई होप दिस इज क्लियर टू यू. रेस्ट ऑल वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट. So why, and again, why has SEBI approved the approved phasing out the shares through the stock exchange method buyback offer? Because of the recommendation given by the KK Mistry report. So ye report aapke liye bahut important hai, aapko yaad rakhna padega, that based on the recommendation given by the KK Mistry report, SEBI has finally given the approval to the proposal that it will phase out the buyback of shares through the stock exchanges method. ठीक है, अब problem क्या थी, क्या KK report ने बताया था? KK report ने ये बताया था कि जो भी buyback होती है stock exchange method के अंदर, that is prone to misuse. Misuse कैसे? The same thing that we have discussed. There are possibility that any one shareholder's entire trade gets matched with the purchase order placed by the company. तो अगर 100 है जो company purchase back करनी चाहती है, and if that matches to one shareholder, in that case जो भी benefit है buyback की, that goes to that one shareholder, and in that case other smaller shareholders are deprived from availing the benefit of the buyback. Apart from that, our chairman of SEBI has also said that these shareholders are these open market offer or the stock exchange offer is also vulnerable to favoritism. जहाँ पे कई बार the small shareholders are unaware of the buyback process of the company. And therefore, in order to create a level playing field for all the shareholders, this proposal has been given approved or is approved by SEBI. Apart from that, SEBI has also favored that repurchase should be done through the tender offer only, and it has also reduced the timeline for the completion of buyback by 18 days. So tender offer ke andar jitna bhi time lagta tha, let's say agar 60 days lagti thi, to usko ab unhone 18 days se kam kar diya hai, right? So this is another operational detail given by SEBI. So this was all that I wanted to discuss with you. I hope aapko samajh aa gaya hoga. In case if you are liking the way we are teaching, then you can also go and look out at our live classes whereby in time resolution of your doubts are provided. Also, you can download our app from the Google Play Store in order to get access to the daily quizzes, the videos, the YouTube videos and its notification. Apart from that, topper strategy, the past year papers and the monthly magazines. Now let's move forward to the question. The first question on the screen says, which of the following financial regulator has issued a regulatory framework for distribution of capital market products and services? So it is none other than the global financial regulator, that is IFSCA, and option C is the correct answer to this question. Moving forward to the next question, which says, which of the following is or are true? So we need to identify the correct statements about the recent regulatory framework. The first, it says that portfolio management services and investment advisory services are parts of capital market products. We have studied products nahi honge, they are part of the services, capital market services, and therefore this statement is incorrect. Moving forward, the second statement, which says distributors are allowed to collaborate with other distributors from India and IFSC only. Again, this is wrong, because distributors have been given the opportunity to collaborate with any distributor that can be from India, from IFSC, as well as from abroad. So ye statement bhi aapka galat ho gaya. Third, any registered distributor should maintain a net worth of at least $50,000 at all times, US dollars. This is correct. Yehi net worth ki criteria thi. And we need to identify the correct statement, and therefore option A, 3 only, is the correct answer here. Moving forward, next question that we have. The question says, recently SEBI extended the suspension on derivatives trading in agricultural commodities. With regards to this, which of the following statement is incorrect? Ab hume incorrect statements identify karne hai. The first statement says, derivatives helps in hedging price risk, which is actually very true. Second, through derivatives trading, people can take informed decisions based on the reliable price signals. Actually, investors consider the price signal given by the derivatives trading to be very reliable. So this statement is correct. Third, derivatives are widely regarded as a tool of speculation. Yes. Whereas some people use it as a process or as a method to hedge their risk, other investors or speculators use it as a tool to speculate. So, ye bhi kafi sahi hai. And we need to identify the incorrect statement. So, none of them is incorrect. Therefore, option D is the correct answer here. None would be the correct answer. Moving forward to the last question that we have for today, which says, which of the following is true about buyback of shares by a company? Correct statements identify karne hai first. The maximum limit for buyback is 20% of the aggregate of the paid up capital and free reserves, which is wrong. Maximum is 25%. Second, in India, there are two methods of buyback of shares, tender offer and hard offer. Hame sino ento nahi khelna. It is tender offer and the open market offer or the stock exchanges offer. So, ye hamara statement galat ho jayega. Third, in case of tender offer, 10% of the buyback is reserved for small shareholders. Again, this is wrong. It is 15% of the buyback is reserved for the small shareholders. So, correct statements hame identify karne the, but all of them are incorrect. Therefore, again, option E, none, will be the correct answer here. Again, the answers are provided here in the PDF. In case if you have any doubt with the with whatever we have learned today, you can ask in the comment section. And for the enrolled students, you can make use of the discussion forum. So this was all from my side. I hope you enjoyed the session and keep learning. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.